This is the Bringing Business to Retail podcast, and today I'm going to share with you my top 7 apps for supercharging your retail or e-commerce business.
Welcome to the Bringing Business to Retail podcast on selenaknight.com. Stay ahead of the competition by opening your doors to business experts so you can learn, grow, and be inspired. Passionate about bringing business strategies to independent retailers, please welcome your host, Selena Knight.
Well, hello there, and welcome back to another episode of the Bringing Business to Retail podcast. Now, I'm going to be a little bit upfront and say today's podcast episode caught me off guard. Why? Because when I sat down and scheduled all of the podcast topics that I wanted to record in the first quarter of 2020, I missed out that there is an extra month in January. I know. It should have been so simple and easy. And had I put dates on everything, it would have been fine. But somehow I managed to overlook this week. And so when I sat down to record the podcast, didn't have a particular topic in mind. Now, just a little bit of background about how the podcast works. Quite some time ago, we had a really great editorial calendar, and that was based on the fact that we would have a theme each month, and that theme could be something like email marketing or sales or health and wellness. And then we would curate all of our content around that particular topic, and it worked fabulously. But somewhere along the lines, the wheels fell off and everything became a little bit more random. I think it was a case of, as the business grew and more people came on board, I really struggled with which parts of which jobs I should retain and what I should be giving to my team. Now, that has been tightened up quite a lot, and I'm relinquishing a lot more of those tasks in my business to my team. I mean, hey, that's what they're there for. They're usually better at that thing than I am. But when you're the visionary of the business, the person who decides the courses of action that we're going to take and the end result that we want to achieve, it means that you shouldn't really be getting bogged down in the nitty-gritty, in the doing work. It's the same as being a CEO. The CEO of a business isn't out there unpacking boxes. The CEO is hired to keep control of the business. And that is something that 2019 taught me. I've always thought I was pretty in control of my business, but sometimes I think I was maybe too much in control. So 2019 was that big shake-up year for me and for our business. And I think I'm getting a lot better at delegating. And with that means you have to have systems and processes in place, right? And me, I love a good system. I mean, systems and processes just mean you don't have to do the work forever. Maybe you're doing it now, but it means when the time comes, you can easily hand that task over to somebody else. In fact, I love systems so much. I don't know if I've mentioned this here on the podcast before, but I recently was made treasurer of our local scouts group, basically because nobody else would do it. Now, in university, accounting was not my strong point. In fact, I failed my first ever module of accounting. But when I came to running my own business, all of a sudden, the money stuff made sense. Instead of just numbers on a page, it translated to money. And that's probably my biggest tip, is if you really struggle, if you're still doing your own bookwork and you struggle with the concept of the numbers on the page, once you think about it as money, like money going into your till, money that you're paying out, money that you're handing over, money that you're receiving, all of a sudden, it really does make sense. And sometimes, even now, I literally have this vision in my head if I'm trying to work out where the money stuff goes, if I haven't had a chance to ask my bookkeeper or accountant, I literally just picture in my head, is this money that would be coming into my bank account or coming into my till, or is it money that I would be handing over to somebody else? And that just helps me reconcile. And if I was handing the money over to somebody else, so if I'm paying for something, where did that money come from? So that just helps me reconcile the whole concept of accounting. And I don't know why they don't teach it like that in school. If they taught it like that, I would have got it right the first time. So I've now become the treasurer, and I was handed an Excel spreadsheet and a bunch of pieces of paper. And of course, if you know me, if you've ever worked with me, that does not wash. And so the first thing that I've done is move everything over to some free accounting software. And with that, we no longer accept cash. Because what was happening was the parents were turning up to an activity or for registration with cash. Or sometimes if they didn't have cash, we didn't get the money. Sometimes for weeks and people would have to chase it up. Now, there is no more cash. People get invoices. We have upped the price a couple of dollars to cover the credit card processing fees. And the money simply goes into the bank account. And when things need to be paid, I pay them out. It sounds so simple, really. But when you're a group of volunteers, and I'm telling you this because what I'm about to say is sometimes if you don't know this thing exists and if you don't know that it's going to make your life easier, then you just overlook it. And this is exactly what's happened with Scouts as a volunteer organization. The people who've been in charge of treasury in the past have not had the knowledge that I've had. They haven't realized there's free accounting software out there. And perhaps when they did it, that didn't exist. So as technology is changing, and this is a theme that I'm going to talk about a lot today, as technology is changing, it is super important to keep up. Because if you don't, you're likely going to be wasting so much time and energy doing stuff that is going to be way easier. So prime example is invoicing the parents for our quarterly fees. It's so much easier to just send an email and let them pay by credit card than it is to have the leaders with a piece of paper ticking people off as they go. And then if the person hasn't been ticked off, they have to phone or they have to call them or they have to email the treasurer and ask them to chase it up. There's so many bits of the puzzle that it's easy for any one of those wheels to fall off and to break, right? So in this case, it's simple. If something happened to me and I ended up in hospital, the group leader can just log in and see who hasn't paid their invoices and press a button and an email reminder goes out. Simple. How many hours of time and even more the mental bandwidth, the frustration that it frees up just from this one little piece of technology. Sure, it's taken me a while to set up, but it won't ever have to be done again. And this is why I love hacking the system, guys. And hopefully by the end of this episode, I'm going to convince you that you should be hacking the system as well. The system being any of your systems. Because as a business owner, you are, if you're anything like me, you're constantly juggling balls. If you're starting out, there might be a lot more of those balls to juggle. But even as you grow and you start to delegate and outsource, just like I was talking about earlier, there are still more balls, more complex balls that require juggling. And if you're a parent, you're juggling all of those things. If you've got a partner or if you're a family carer, you have all of these balls that you're trying to keep in the air. And inevitably, some of them are going to drop, right? So my goal in life is to get rid of as many balls as possible and just live a much better, easier, freer life. Last year, as I've mentioned on many of the podcasts, and the reason I'm telling you this, guys, is because just to show you that I've been in business 15 years now, just to show you that you can be a business veteran and still got stuff wrong and still make mistakes. I mean, it's part of being human. So last year, when my business went through some monumental changes, we had staff onboarding, staff offboarding, is that a word? Offboarding? Leaving. We had new programs, changes in direction, and it was a true roller coaster ride. But what that did reaffirm for me is that in order to weather those highs and lows and not end up rocking in a corner somewhere, you have to have systems in place. And you've got to find ways to hack those systems so that both you and your team, if you haven't got a team yet, you'll get a team, but you won't get the team very easily if you haven't got the systems. You can't be working for the sake of working. You can't be reinventing the wheel every time your business moves up a notch. And so I was sitting here thinking about today's episode. What can I talk about? And it just hit me. I picked up my phone to answer a text message and I was looking at the apps on the front page of my phone. You know, you can scroll, you've got loads of pages. And I thought, do you know what? I was actually thinking, one of those apps I don't use very much and I should move it off. And I was like, you know what? This is what I should talk about. What are the apps that are going to make your life easier? What are the apps that are going to supercharge your business here and now in 2020? Because it's what I get asked for by all of my clients. Whenever someone comes on you, they're always asking, what program can I use for this? What can I do to make this easier? And in fact, I actually have one former client. I know that she listens. You know who you are. She calls me the app queen. She's like, Sal's always got an app to do something. And I'll be honest, I have no problems paying a few dollars a month if it is going to save me money, or if it's going to save me time, or if it's going to give me better customer experience, or if it's going to free up some mental bandwidth for me. And that one is huge for me. Like, there is a price on my sanity, and I am quite often prepared to pay for it, even though I can be a bit of a cheapskate at times. So I did a couple of things to prep for this episode. The first one was look at what is on the first two pages of my home screen on my phone. And the other one was to go through the latest subscription purchases on my credit card. And the last two that I paid for were, one was a website called Free Pick, and it is a site where you can superimpose your images onto mock-ups of computers and notepads and iPhones and whatnot. So we've used that in our shop. We've superimposed images of the screen or the book or the product onto iPads and phones. Now, probably, unless you're in the tech industry, not high on your list of things. The next one that I purchased was Elementor, which is a page builder for our WordPress site. Now, this is a paid for thing, and you're probably thinking, well, but there's loads of page builders out there for free. And sure, Elementor actually has a free version, but the pro version literally has saved us hours of time because it does things like pull content from other pages so it populates dynamically. So instead of one of my team having to go and put, say, some information on one page and then copy it across to the shop and then copy it across to the portal, we can actually do that dynamically. Once it populates everywhere. So that has saved me hours, which means it saves me money because I'm not paying my team to do that stuff. Now, the thing is, I'm not going to harp on about it because if you're using WordPress, you're probably using a WooCommerce theme. So Elementor can be used with WooCommerce, but if you're already using a theme, it's kind of not on your high on your list of priorities. Now, the last time I did one of these favorite apps type podcasts was in 2016. And just to show you how times have changed, but how some things stay the same, my top apps back then were Google Calendar, number one. And I have to say, probably still ranks number one in our household because we use it for everything. Because I travel, because Ed travels, because Lana has activities, because my team do things, we have Google Calendar that pretty much runs our lives. When I had my shop fronts, my staff used to use it for their rostering. So for me, Google Calendar was awesome back in 2016, still awesome today. The next one on my list was Grum, which was scheduling software for Instagram. We use a different program now called eClincher because it will post into groups and it will also post into LinkedIn and Pinterest and places like that. Haven't used Grum for a while, but scheduling software, still high on my list of priorities. The next one was ConvertKit. Now, ConvertKit was an email marketing, or is an email marketing platform, but that was before I discovered Klaviyo, and I'm going to talk about Klaviyo in a minute, and you know, I am like a Klaviyo fangirl. The next one was LastPass. I'm not going to talk about that one today, but if you aren't using LastPass, or I think there's another one called 1Password maybe, you got to get it. It's free, and it's a vault that holds all of your passwords. I have it on my phone, and I have it on my computers, all of my computers. We have a family LastPass account, so if anything ever happens to us, we can get access to the other person's information. Awesome, awesome, awesome. So that, still a must. My still a must things are Google Calendar and LastPass. Stocard, again, still use that daily. It's just a little app on your phone that you put all of your loyalty cards into. So instead of carrying around a handbag full of loyalty cards, they're all on your phone. Next was Trello. Now, we do still use Trello a little bit, but Personally, we've moved everything to another program that I'm going to talk about in the podcast today. So Trello, still kind of good, and I know lots of businesses who use Trello. And my last one was Android Pay. Well, here's a sign of the times. I don't have an Android device anymore. I have an iPhone. So Apple Pay now ranks very, very highly as well. In fact, I got really excited recently because here in New South Wales, in Australia, you no longer have to carry around your driver's license. You have an app that you can authenticate that has your license. So now I do not need a handbag ever again. I can order an Uber, I can pay for my groceries, and I can drive, all as long as I have my phone. So it is really important to keep up with what's current right now, even if it means not carrying around a 20 loyalty cards or being able to drive without your driver's license, because technology changes at such a super fast pace. And if you're using something that's outdated, it isn't updated regularly, or it hasn't kept up with how far your business has moved forward, then just like I was saying earlier, it's costing you time and money. So you're probably thinking, Sal, what are these must-have apps for retail and e-commerce businesses for 2020, the new decade? Now, just a disclaimer, some of these aren't technically apps in the sense that you run them off your phone. Some of them are SaaS products, and SaaS is software as a service. So it's a web-based program that runs as an interface, but you're paying for it as you would an app. Anyway, you know what I'm talking about. They're programs that you use to do stuff, make your life easier. But just for the ease of making a podcast title, I thought that the 7 best apps to supercharge your retail or e-commerce business was much more succinct. Now, just a heads up, normally when you read these kinds of articles, now obviously you're not reading this, you're listening to it, but if you went and Googled best apps for retail business or best apps for e-commerce business, one, you're probably going to get apps that add on to other things like Shopify apps or WooCommerce apps. That's not what we're talking about here today. We're talking about kind of standalone products that are going to make your life easier. But the other thing is they're quite often just listicles. So that's a technical term for like a blog post that's just full of lists of things. And they're created because someone is going to get an affiliate commission if you go ahead and either click through and sign up for a trial or if you actually purchase the product. So they're kind of handy, but quite often they're just what I like to call affiliate link clickbait. And the person who's created that list maybe hasn't actually used the software, so you don't know whether it's good or not. But I'm going to tell you that the ones that are here today that I'm going to talk about are the ones that we truly do use in our business. And I think I'll go down the list, but I think we're only affiliate for 2 of them, Klaviyo and Canva Pro. So you can rest assured that all the stuff I'm going to share with you today, these things are the real deal, and they're the ones that I use, and they're the ones that I implement in my retail and e-commerce clients' businesses to make their life easier. All right, you ready? Okay, the first one is called Teleprompter App, and I'm going to tell you it's by a company called Joe Allen Pro, because if you type in Teleprompter App into the App Store, you'll probably get a gazillion of them. And looking at my phone, it's on a black background with a red sort of video camera. But if you type in Joe Allen Pro, I'm sure you will find it. Now, why do I love this app? Because if you are scared of recording video because you never know what to say, or if you've put off creating video because you don't think you've got the perfect setup, this app is for you. It is the secret behind all of my pre-recorded videos. So I do record quite a few videos just off the cuff for my training groups, just in front of the computer. I don't use the teleprompter app for this. I use the teleprompter app for things like Facebook ads, or if I'm doing courses, or if I'm doing a tutorial, like a proper face-to-camera tutorial. Honestly, this thing is game-changing, because it has saved my bacon so many times. But not only that, it's actually up-leveled the content that we produce, because I used to have to get lights out and get the teleprompter out and set it all up. It would take like an hour and a half just to get ready before I recorded the video. Now, as long as I've got a backdrop and some makeup and some, I just stand near the window, I can just go for it. So I have no excuse now not to record good video. I've actually ditched the teleprompter and the light setup, the collecting dust in the cupboard, because this app works so well. Now, it has the text coming across the side of your camera, so it looks like you're looking into the camera. And there is a free version, but it does have some branding down the bottom. It's up to you whether you want to keep the branding if you're just using it for maybe social media, or you can upgrade it. I think I paid about $15 to take the branding off, but best $15 I have ever spent. So the first app that is going to up-level your business and stop you from procrastinating when it comes to video is Teleprompter App by Joe Allen Pro. And before I get into the next one, someone mentioned to me the other day, Sal, you always like to have numbers of things. Is that like a marketing strategy? I was like, what do you mean? And they said, oh, well, you always like five ways to do something, or six things to do, three ways that you could. I was like, no. Like, I'm sure that I could probably find some marketing reason that everything has three or four or five or seven. But quite simply, I am so type A that it is just way easier for me to work in dot points and numbers and just work my way down a list. So just a little fun fact, the reason that you always have five or four or three or seven is quite simply because my brain works better that way. So the first app was Teleprompter App. The second app is called Otter. O-T-T-E-R. So continuing on with that theme of video and words, one of the most popular questions that I get asked is, how do you do subtitles when I create a video? So if you've used Teleprompter App, then how do you get the subtitles in? Well, subtitles aren't just for hard of hearing people, okay? They're also good for social media. And a lot of people who are scrolling through their Facebook feed or their Instagram feed, they don't want to hear your videos. But it doesn't mean that they aren't interested, right? So the key to getting your videos clicked on and opened, or your ads opened, is subtitles. But working out how to make them, not always that easy. So subtitles are going to be a game changer for your video. And that is why I love the Otter app. We used to send our text off to be created into what's called an SRT file, but Otter does it for you for free. Now, Otter is primarily a speech-to-text app. So you talk into it and it will just take notes for you. It's actually really good. You know, a lot of that, those dictation type apps, they're really, really not very good at all. They're really crap. This one is amazing. And I actually discovered it when I was practicing for my live events, practicing my presentations, because I was recording them and the dictation was awesome because then I could see what I wanted to change. I just would export the text out and change, and then I'd go back to recording again. But then I accidentally stumbled across it for another thing, which is to play the video on my laptop with the Otter app running on my phone. So what I do, because Otter actually creates timestamps for you as well, so the text is in line with what you're saying. So once you've got your video, you play it on your laptop or on your computer and just put your phone next to it with Otter running, and it will transcribe it for you. So then once you've got the text, you just export it as what's called a .srt file, and then you upload that into your social media. Now, I will just say that Facebook sometimes does this for you as well. It's very hit and miss. I've defaulted to always add subtitles. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. So this is a great way to always make sure that you've got subtitles. Now, of course, Otter is also really good for recording notes or even recording processes. So if you talk your way through when you're creating a process, you can then just export the text. So you can create a hard copy and print it out, or you can just create a Word doc or something similar like that. Now, personally, I like having that step-by-step copy when I'm learning. So Otter can help you scale your business, save you time, save your money, increase your customer experience, especially when it comes to processes, all for the princely sum of $0. Yes, It is free. You can upgrade it, but you get 600 minutes of transcription a month, and even I struggle to hit that amount. So Otter is my second favorite app. My next one, and I have to admit, I wasn't going to include this, but when I mentioned today that I was going, this is what I was going to talk about, Elizabeth jumped in and said, we have to include Canva Pro. So Canva Pro is not an app on your phone, or maybe it is, I don't know, I don't use it. It's primarily a SaaS product, so software as a service. So you log in and you purchase the product to basically operate as if it was a program on your computer. Now, I don't use Canva a lot, but Elizabeth, who does our graphics, does. So I didn't think to include this, but she was like, nope, you have to. The people who are out there are probably doing their own graphics, and this is going to change their business. So Canva is, if you're not familiar with it, it's a web-based graphic design program. And the thing about Pro, and I had to ask Elizabeth this because she's the one who uses it, I was like, why would you pay to use this program? And she said, it saves you so much time. So she didn't say it saves her so much time, it saves me as the employer so much time. Because if you want to resize, this is primarily why she loves Canva Pro. When you create an image for social media, you have a different size for Pinterest, a different size for Instagram, different size for Facebook, all the things. But with Canva Pro, you can create one image and then click a button and it will magically resize it to all the different platforms. She says that in itself saves her sometimes 45 minutes to an hour because recreating them takes a lot of time. So already I've saved an hour's worth of wages by having that program. Now, when you have Pro, Elizabeth tells me you also get to be able to remove backgrounds, you get access to stock photos, you can make GIFs, and you can also put in your own custom branding. But Elizabeth asked me to say, if you can't afford your own graphic designer, then you have to get Canva Pro. And this is one of the products that we are an affiliate for because she is so passionate about it. So if you're interested, click on the link. There's a free trial and you can decide whether you want to go ahead and use it or not after the 30 days. Next up is, we've talked about video a lot, right? But maybe you're not really keen to get in front of the camera. And I can totally understand that. I still want you to try and overcome it, but my next app is going to help you to jump into the video scene without actually having to get on camera. And it is a product called, again, it's a SaaS product called Wave Video, W-A-V-E Video. And the reason I love it is because when it comes to social media, video is king. This is so particularly important for e-commerce. If you have great product videos, especially in things like Facebook ads, one, they'll get shares, two, they'll get comments, and three, they will probably convert better. So video is the most powerful tool that you probably have in your marketing arsenal. And that means you need a quick way to create video. And if you're anything like me, graphics and video, not my thing. So with Wave Video, and this is a paid for product, I think it is about, I'm going to go out on a limb and say about $79 a year, but I could be completely incorrect there. But they have templates. So they have all the animations and everything put in. All you have to do is drop your pictures in, and there are even stock photos that you can use. But of course, if you're doing it for product, you probably want to drop a couple of pictures of products in there. Add some text into the area where the text is. In fact, in some of them, you don't even have to add text. It has things like shop now. And you can create a video in, I'm gonna say 3 minutes. That's how easy it is. And I'm pretty sure Wave has a free trial as well. I really should have researched this one more for you. But I wanted to include it because video is so powerful. And if you are anything like me and that whole designer thing is not working for you, Wave is simple, it's easy, you've got the templates there, you just drop stuff in and you've got videos ready to go. It does take a little bit of a play around to get used to, but once you've got it, you'll be creating those videos like no tomorrow. Okay, next up, so far, what have we had so far? We've had teleprompter for video, we've had Otter for transcription and for subtitles, we've had Canva Pro for graphics and Wave Video for videos. My next one is Dropbox. And if you have not been using Dropbox, then you need some kind of file saving software. Lots of people I know use Google Drive or OneDrive. Let me tell you why I like Dropbox. Because now that you're producing all this wonderful content, the videos and the audios, they're going to take up a lot of space on your computer. And you're probably going to need to share these with other people if you have a team. So the reason I like Dropbox, and I will preface this with, this is only on the, I'm pretty sure it's only on the paid version, which I pay about 10 Australian dollars a month, is that you can sync everything to the cloud. I guess it's kind of like iCloud. You sync everything to the cloud so it doesn't take space up on your hard drive. But if you want to access it, you just click the button and it will suck the information down. So it'll suck the document down or the graphic or the image. But for me, because I have a lot of images and a lot of video and a lot of graphics on my computer, it's meant that my computer actually works again. I don't know about you, but very, very quickly, I fill up my hard drives. And this has allowed me to free up my hard drives so that my computers actually still run. So it's called Smart Sync. So you can Smart Sync everything to be in the cloud, and then you just use the little Dropbox app, or you can use Finder if you're in a Mac, and it will show you that it's in the cloud, and you just click a button, and then it, you know, within a second, it just sucks the thing down and you're ready to go. So we use Dropbox to house all of our files, because when we have a remote team, people need to access the documents that we have. So everybody needs to have this stuff in the cloud so that they can get access to it. But Dropbox also has comments. So you know that back and forth thing that you do with people with email? I don't like that. At least in Dropbox, all the comments are sitting in the document. So as we want to change something, we can just put the comments in. Now you would use this too if you were doing things like blog posts, or if you're creating your marketing programs, or if you're creating ads, any kind of data, even in your processes, if you need to update it, you can add the comments in, and then the author of the document can go through and choose whether to keep the comments or change the document. Dropbox saves us loads of time, and it is worth the $10 a month. Now, by now, it's probably pretty clear to you guys that I can't stand that whole email back and forth thing. It's just a waste of everybody's time. It's like having meetings for the sake of having meetings. It is the bane of my existence. It drives me insane. It wastes everybody's time. It wastes money. And honestly, sometimes it's just talking for the sake of talking or typing for the sake of typing. And if you haven't realized that I don't like doing things more than once, then let me tell you now, I don't like doing things more than once. So call it lazy, call it smart. But if I can reduce having to sift through my inbox, I am all for it. Which is why we pretty much run our entire business through this Next app, which is an app on your phone as well as a SaaS product called Asana, or Asana, as we Australians like to call it. So the same as a yoga pose, that is what it is called. We literally run our entire business on it. Every single task that we do is a task in Asana. So if I put a task in, I allocate it to somebody, or if they have a job, they'll put it in there. So at any time, we can all see what everybody is working on. Now, sure, you can have private stuff, but for me, it's great as the leader to see, to be able to click on each of my team and see what it is they're working on. So I can choose whether to prioritize their projects, or I can give work to somebody else, or I can divvy things up, or I can choose to put it off till next week. So even better is all of the comments, essentially like emails, are within each project. So say we've got a simple project called podcast. Now that actual project does exist. There is a project called podcast, and there is a template, and every single part of the podcast is a subtask. So each week we just replicate that, and it just means that everybody knows the bits and pieces. And I think there are about 35 subtasks in the podcast project. So you can see that if we didn't have them listed out, it's really easy for something to get overlooked. Now, nobody likes getting stuff overlooked, so this is our way of avoiding it. So if I pick up the phone and call one of my team and ask a question, usually the first answer they have back is that in Asana? Or, and if it's not, can you add that in Asana and assign it to me? It just means at any time, we can personally keep track of the tasks that we need to do. We can upload documents that are relative. So we quite often do screen shares or we do video recordings of things just to make life easier. If you're trying to show somebody how to do something, you can have screen shares, processes, links, it's all in there. And guys, it is free. Yes, you can upgrade. We did upgrade to the paid version, but we didn't really use any of the paid features. So for you guys listening, it is going to probably, the free version is probably going to be all that you need. And you will be surprised how much your life gets freed up when you use a project management software like Asana, or Asana, as we Australians like to call it. Honestly, things as simple as unpacking stock. If you have a process, you can put the process in and then just replicate the process. So when stock comes in, what happens to it? Who puts it into the point of sale software? Who puts the stickers on it? Who uploads it to the website? All those things. Who resizes images? All those things can just be taskified. Is that a word? Taskified? So if someone leaves and the job's not finished, it can just get assigned to somebody else. Again, it's all this back and forthing, the to and froing. If I can get rid of that, if I can help you get rid of that, I feel like I have just like done my job for today. Okay. Now, my last one is, and you know that I rave about this all the time, but my last app that you should 100% be using in your retail or e-commerce business is Klaviyo. And I can't rave about it enough. It's email marketing that is made for e-commerce and retail. And I have to say that pretty much every client that we ever move over to Klaviyo from, say, MailChimp, or MailChimp is usually where they come from, they see an instant return on investment. So they make their money that it costs for the program back in the first month. And if that happens, then it's, as soon as you make, let's just say it's $79 a month, the minute you make $100, you're instantly in profit. Right? So when you can find software that literally makes you money while you sleep, then I'm all for that. So the reason we love Klaviyo, and like I said, if you've listened to the podcast for a while, you know that it is the bee's knees. And the more time that you put into personalizing it, the more money you're going to make. But it does work out of the box. You can turn on automations straight away. It connects with your Shopify. It connects with your Magento. It connects with your WooCommerce. It has behavioral analysis. It has artificial intelligence. It has personalization software. It is everything that once upon a time, when I first started out in retail, to get this kind of software, you would have been paying $100,000 a year. It just wasn't in our game plan to be having software that did this kind of stuff to this level, this kind of analytics, these personalization, the customer journey. Everything can be tailored. And what I would have given to have this kind of software when I opened my retail business, we were doing all this manually. We used to do this stuff with an Excel spreadsheet every single week. Now it happens in the background. And the best part about it is it increases the customer experience. It makes your life so much easier. Once you've spent the time setting it up, it makes you money while you sleep. So it is the number one e-commerce software that we recommend when it comes to email marketing. And it's got a really funny name, doesn't it? It's one of those, is it Klaviyo? Is it Klaviyo? It's spelled Klaviyo. And I'll pop a link to it in the show notes. That is an affiliate link. So if you decide to go ahead and use it, then we get a commission. But it is free for up to 250 customers. So what I usually recommend is put your top 250 customers in there, give it a go, see how it works. I'm pretty sure that you'll probably make some money with it straight away. And at that point, usually most people are sold. Then they move all of their customers over and they make their business so much easier and faster and more profitable. Now, it's easy to fall into the trap of doing things the same way because that's the way that they've always been done. But if you aren't keeping up with technology, I can honestly say that you're losing customers because it doesn't take much for your competitors to get ahead. And the same thing goes for sales. If you're not putting systems in place to get your customers to come back and buy from you, you are losing tens, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars every single year. Recovering even just a fraction of those lost sales makes a huge difference to your overall profitability. And if you want some help with that, I have got you covered because I created a workbook. It's called, funnily enough, the Recovering Lost Sales Workbook, and you'll find it in my new shop over at theretailacademy.net/shop. It is really easy to fall into that trap of doing things because it's just easier for you to do it rather than to teach somebody else or to take the time to write or record a process or simply just invest some time and maybe a little bit of money into learning a new app like the ones on this list to help you grow. But for your own sanity and for the growth of your business, I really do hope you at least just take some time out and investigate whether these apps will work for you. So just quickly, I'll go over them again. We had Teleprompter app by Joellen Pro, Otter, Canva Pro, Wave Video, Dropbox, Asana, and Klaviyo. And of course, make sure to check out theretailacademy.net/shop, where you can grab not only my Recovering Lost Sales workbook, but a bunch of other workbooks and action plans to help you grow your retail or e-commerce business. That's it from me. Have a fantastic week. Stay profitable, and I'll speak to you next week. Bye. I hope you enjoyed this week's episode of the Bringing Business to Retail podcast. You can find all of the show notes over at selenanight.com. If you found something that you heard today particularly useful, I'd love it if you could leave me a review on iTunes or Stitcher. And of course, feel free to share this episode with someone that you think could benefit by listening to it. Want more retail biz strategies? You can watch the Bringing Business to Retail TV show, where each week I'll answer a question or provide you with a simple, actionable retail biz strategy that you can implement in your business right away. If you have a question or a guest, I'd love to hear from you. Drop my team an email at podcast@selenanight.com, and I'll see you on the next episode. Have a great week.